weekend on Radio 1, and for that matter the nighttime too, it's a different proposition from the daytime output, featuring not only mainstream music, but also the more specialised brands of rock, reggae, soul and funk, to say nothing of documentaries and even comedy, as presented by such as Jeff Young, Robbie Vincent, The Ranking Miss P, Andy Kershaw, DLT, Tommy Vance, Annie Nightingale, Adrian Just, Andy Peebles, and Nicky Campbell. A weekend broadcasting with a difference took place in 1987 when Radio 1 took over the Pontins holiday camp at Prestatyn and presided over 2 days of, well, perhaps that's best left to the imagination.
Radio 1's constantly trying to find ways of getting out and talking to people. Not just sending one disc jockey and a producer, but the whole lot of the daytime presenters, or sometimes the weekend guys, along with producers and engineering staff and executives. And that means that, for example, we did the Pontins weekend last year in 1987, and whenever we do the Weeks Away that we do, which are pretty hysterical and chaotic but tremendous fun, you'll find the disc jockeys doing two, maybe three nights of discotheques, of disco appearances. And those are an integral part, again, of meeting people and of getting people to meet us. Otherwise, if we stayed in the confines of our own studio all the time, then there would be another worldliness. Is this voice belonging to a body, or is it just a shadowy figure that comes out of the ether at me?
Well, these people certainly aren't after a shadowy figure from the ether. You know, it's amazing what length some people will go to catch a glimpse of a real celebrity. Someone like Simon Bates, for example. But I guess some of us have got it, and some of us just haven't. Or is it Simon they've come to see? Oh, I think the haircuts give it away.
One of the advantages of working for Radio 1 and having a name within Radio 1 is that the artists will tend to ignore the American radio stations and television companies that are there and will come to Radio 1 and talk to us. You make friends. I believe this country has the most talented musicians. And also the most generous musicians, and also engineers and producers, and people who support those musicians. If we treat them with respect, they do the same to us, and I've always found them to be very generous.
Join the party, that's
have
fine.
A party. Have
yeah.
a party.
You know, don't worry about if it's cool, if it's credible, it's fun, that's what we are. We're
that's
young
right.
and fun.
Oh. Listen, fingers crossed as if you need it. Go for it.
Good luck. Simon.
Good luck.
Great.
See you, fellas. Thank you.
Bye. See you, Simon.
Well, 7:30, brass are about to go on stage, and for most of us the evening's just beginning. Not all of us, though. For some, it's already time to go to bed. Good night, Adrian. Sleep tight, mate. Meanwhile, nighttime on Radio 1 continues with Liz Kershaw.
Well, you might remember some time ago the Rhythm Sisters came into the studio and played a couple of live songs for us and had a bit of a chat with us in the evening. It's the time when Radio 1, unlike a lot of commercial stations, doesn't take the safe bet and will let people hear music which otherwise they wouldn't get on any other radio station.
Records, American Boys.
We always assume, rightly or wrongly, that a large part of our audience is actually listening to the radio at this time of day and wants information, what label a record's on or who's in session, or information on tour dates, so they're actually listening.
I knew there was a reason we played this record on this program.
The only reason.
Right, now,
the evening on Radio 1's a part of the day when you can be a bit more experimental and where if you really, really like something, you can give it an airing.
We'll stick that one on.
We played a record one night and immediately a record company rang up and said, do you know where that band have got to? So I said on the air, are you still in existence? And then the band rang up and we put the band and the record company together and they've now been signed up by this major record company.
The Rhythm Sisters and the new single, American Boys. Well, let's have something a bit more fast and frantic, shall we now? From the Godfather's album,
album, Hit by Hit. This is This Damnation. There's no greater pleasure than concentrating on something that you actually like, which is records and music and bands. So it's, many people said this before, but it's like being paid for living out your hobby 7 days a week.
Nighttime, and one of the institutions of Radio 1, as long serving as the station itself, the John Peel Show.
Wherever the programme was, it would be as it is. At times in the past, I felt that there was a possibility that it might be moved before the Immigrants programme on a Sunday morning at about 4:30, and if it was on there, or if it was on first thing in the morning, it would be essentially the same. I'd be jollier in the morning, but... Because obviously by 10 o'clock at night I tend to be feeling a bit tired.
Hi pals, on tonight's programme we've got sessions for you from The Wedding Present and from Germany, Freiwilliger Selbstkontrolle, all the way from Germany, as we DJs say, and any number of exhilarating records, of which this from Ripcord is but the first.
Some of the things I realise, if you put them on over breakfast, might cause a certain amount of alarm. But people assume when that point is made that these programmes that I do are designed in some way to provoke, you know, and to irritate. But it's not really the case. I mean, it's just that there are things that I find interesting or exciting, and I just want to play them on the radio, really. And people can take them or leave them, which of course they do. Well, it's very easy, actually, when you're discussing radio programmes and your involvement with them and who you think's listening to them, to get into kind of Bob Hope-style showbiz sentimentality of the most nauseating kind. But the truth of the matter is that I started doing radio programmes, really, that were nothing more than just playing records that I liked for my friends.
Radio 1 now broadcasts until 2 in the morning. That's 21 hours a day, 21 years of non-stop music.
My dream had always been to work for Radio 1. I mean, it is the ultimate. It's the only national radio station in the country. And it's the station that I listened to as a kid. And I suppose every disc jockey in the country wants to work for Radio 1 at some time or other.
What anybody wants to do, if they're any kind of a performer, which is what DJs are really, is they want the biggest audience for what they do. And Radio 1 has always had the biggest audience, always will have the biggest audience.
When I first began to think I'd love to be a DJ, Radio 1 was the only pinnacle, it's the only place I wanted to go in the end, and I wasn't really bothered how long it took me to get there. Forget it, brother. You can go
it alone. I own Radio 1. As a lot of people didn't think that at first, but it is, in fact, my station, and all the DJs and all the staff, all the producers, and God bless him, our little controller. I booked them all. They all work for me, and I could do a later show, but I choose to do this early spot because it's so romantic and so personal, so intimate.
Turn that thing off!
Sorry.